Sidewalks. They're everywhere. Big sidewalks, little sidewalks, sidewalks with trees, with benches, with trash cans and signs, sidewalks that go everywhere, and sidewalks that go absolutely nowhere. There are 1,001 ways to design a sidewalk, but not all sidewalks are created equal. What makes up a sidewalk? Well, it can help to think of a sidewalk like a tunnel with walls and a floor.
Now, there are two walls in a sidewalk. There's the service zone and the transition zone. The service zone is where amenities like benches, trash cans, and access to crosswalks are. The transition zone is a space where sidewalks interact with the street wall, giving pedestrians access to buildings and shops. Then there's the floor, also called the free zone. This is where planners have the most control. The floor is where pedestrians get to move around, walk, dance, or meet with each other. It's the area most important to the basic function of a sidewalk, though all areas should be considered when making the best sidewalk possible.
Now that we know about the areas of a sidewalk, it's time to learn about the elements that make a sidewalk better for everyone. There's the elements of accessibility, safety, comfort, scale, and convenience.
Accessible sidewalks can be used by nearly anyone and follow the 8-to-80 rule. They have features such as lowered curbs at intersections, rumble strips to alert people they're approaching the street, and plenty of benches and shade for pedestrians to rest. Sidewalks should also be safe for users. Studies show that raised, curbed sidewalks provide a buffer from cars that make accidents that do happen less deadly. There's also new technology making sidewalks safer, such as these light-up curb strips that work to turn lanes into crosswalks and alert pedestrians on their phones as to whether or not it's safe to cross. Not all sidewalk designs will work for every street. Sidewalks should be human-sized and appropriate for each area. Sidewalks that are really wide in a low-traffic area can feel underutilized or sterile, while narrow sidewalks in areas of high usage can become congested and deter people from walking. It may be necessary to monitor sidewalks and their usage and make sure that the scale is appropriate and meeting the needs of the neighborhood.
Now, personally, I'm a fan of building sidewalks wide. If they're too big, you can always add features such as benches, planters, public art, or even turn sections into parklets. And who doesn't love a stroll around town? Sidewalks with comfort amenities such as benches, shade, art, and plants can attract people like bees to flowers, and occasionally, literal bees.
Beautiful public areas can increase the sense of place for residents and attract new visitors.
And according to Fast Company, walkable neighborhoods are more likely to become exciting and prosperous areas. It's amazing how simple built features like bump outs or stoplets can increase the walkability of a place, adding these benefits to the streetscape.
Finally, there's the matter of convenience. A sidewalk anywhere can be a good thing, but a sidewalk that connects to other sidewalks and amenities is a wonderful thing. Having sidewalks that connect people's homes to transit stops, shops, services, and other networks of sidewalks, greenways, or trails is essential to encouraging people to use sidewalks and get active.
Sidewalks work best when people can use them all the time. That's right, even in winter when Halifax looks like this.
If you can't use the sidewalk in the winter, then, well, what's the point? People have to get around the city all year round, so it's important to make sure the infrastructure is available to use. Residents of an area should be aware and up to date with snow removal policies and know whether they are responsible for clearing their sidewalk or if it's up to the local government.
There's evidence that having sidewalks in a neighborhood increases the chances of residents being physically active. Turns out that having a safe place to walk and exercise makes people want to get outside and move.
Good sidewalks can also attract good neighbors. In a 2013 study, researchers found that areas with well-maintained sidewalks and streets were more likely to attract long-term residents to invest in their community. Areas with less infrastructure maintenance were less likely to attract home buyers.
Basically, having good sidewalks in an area can provide benefits beyond that of just active transportation. A neighborhood with sidewalks can benefit from increased property values, the eyes on the street effect, an increase in traffic to local businesses, and even just a more beautiful landscape. Sidewalks are a great equalizer. People of all ages and abilities are able to use well-designed sidewalks, and they require less maintenance and cost less to build than highways or roads. Well-built sidewalks can last 25 years or more without needing replacing. So if we're going to build them, let's do it right the first time around.